Very good evening. Myself Vikas Tazan. I'm an engineer by profession, and presently I'm running a platform on social media about the cyber awareness. And my areas of interest is cyber forensics. As you might be aware that Pakistan terror groups, they have been using the cyberspace to recruit the youth into the terror groups and ranks, and modus operandi they are using, it's very alarming. The reason that there is communication blockade still there in Jammu and Kashmir, we don't have the access to the 4G network here in Jammu and Kashmir. I'm audible?
Yes, sir. You're
audible.
Yeah. Now, I'll be discussing one of the case study, how the digital forensics helped a lot in getting the information about the terrorist organization, their association, and where they have been in contact with each other. One of the laptop was received, and it was got from one of the terrorists who was operating in the parts of Jammu and Kashmir. He was planning to carry out various strikes in here. And after the cyber forensic investigation was carried out, various contacts, email messages, and messengers from chat history, cache files, temporary internet files, who could get the information that how these he was in constant touch with the associates and what information he used to carry out with the associates working in other parts of the country and also around in other parts of the country, and also the from the where it has been sponsored, like Pakistan. We can directly talk of the Pakistan who has been sponsoring the terrorism in our country. Next slide, please. So first of all, the laptop was seized and it was in the standby mode. The photographs of the laptop were taken, chain of custody was maintained, and it was brought to the notice that it was the Microsoft Windows, and using the Helix CD software, we could get the ports, running ports that were there. Open Explorer windows were collected, and from that we can get the information regarding the website they have reached, the messages, the chat rooms, the contacts we can get from that place. And before proceeding further, page file dot system file was copied. Actually, it's a RAM dump analysis using a volatility software. We use this and take out the information that is stored in the RAM. And date and time was there. Formal shutdown of the computer was taken down, and it was the RAM dump was copied to an external hard disk like Sony USB without taking the original hard disk into the consideration. Next slide, please. Laptop was unscrewed and the hard disk was removed. As far as the hard disk is concerned, we don't work on the original evidence, and bitstream imaging of the hard disk was carried out. We always work on the image of the hard disk for any device or the memory like USB. We take the image of that and never we work on the original device. Hard disk was stored in anti-static bag, because whenever there is transportation of these devices that carry volatile information, they are carried to the forensic laboratories. They are stored in the anti-static bag so that they are not in contact with any electromagnetic interference that can damage the hard disk and the information stored on it. And as far as the when we carried them to the state forensic lab, MD5 hash values were calculated so that the same can be proved in the court of law that it's the same evidence that we have been collected at the time of site. Chain of custody already discussed that it was maintained during the whole operation. And as far as the file formats, we use the FTK image and various softwares to recover the deleted files from the hard disk that was there in our custody. And various, next slide, please. Images were loaded in Encase, and it was searched for that we come to notice that 500 contacts from the Outlook, 250 video files, image files were recovered from the hard disk, and Word files were there, Excel files were there, and these all provided a volatile information that how these terrorist organizations have been making a propaganda against our country, and using the forensic techniques, we can get the terrorist camps where they have been operating from. They have been in contact with their counterparts in other parts of the country and also up across the borders. Next slide, please. It was noticed that the videos were there. They have been showing the various terror camps they have been operating across the borders, the killing of the kidnapped hostages, and also the motivational speeches they used to tell to the people that you come and join this. And it was very very in-depth investigation that helped a lot to the security agencies of getting into this type of cyber forensic role. Images that were considered during the investigation, like 1200 JPG files, 700 GIF files. Using the EXIF data software, we can get the location of the terrorist camps that were operating from the across the borders, and it proved that it was all the Pakistan-sponsored terrorism. Thank you.